Hi, today we're going to be doing dodging and burning in a non-destructive manner using the curves layer. Now there's a lot of methods to dodging and burning. This is just a nice one I use, which is non-destructive. You can always go back and adjust it as you want. So first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to pull up a curves layer. And now I'm going to select my hand tool. I'm going to look for the lightest spot on the face or the image that I'm going to be dodging and burning. I'm just going to click on that and I'm going to pull it right up. Okay, I'm going to invert the layer mask by pushing Ctrl R. Going to rename this to dodge or highlights or light, whatever suits you. Going to go ahead and pull up another curves layer. This time I'm going to select a shadows area. Okay, the cheek there, I'm going to pull that right down. That looks good. Ctrl R again. Now I'm going to make sure, alright, I don't need these anymore. I'm going to make sure my brush is selected. I'm going to make sure that white color is selected there. And I'm going to start brushing over my layer mask, bringing back the curves adjustment that we did earlier. Now I set for the dodging and burning, let's call this burn. For dodging and burning, I keep my flow on 20 and then I'll adjust my opacity with my number key. So 5 will give me 50%, 8 will give me 80%, etc. I'm going to start on 40% and I'm going to use my close bracket, square bracket key just to adjust my brush size. Okay, and we're going to start with a relatively big brush. I'll start with my dodging layer. Just make sure it's on normal. Okay. Now you want these effects to be subtle. Not overbearing. And what you want to do is the general rule now is you're going to dodge where there's already highlights or where the skin is a bit lighter, and you're going to burn where they're more prominent shadows. And doing that, you're going to be still using the shape of the natural light, but you're just going to be enhancing it a little. Don't forget to do the body as well. Same with skin softening. Okay, at any time you can toggle your layer on and off to see the effect. Right, this is a little bit strong for my liking, but I'll show you how we're going to adjust that now. Now we go over to the burn. I'm actually going to take my opacity down to 20, especially on a high key image like this. You literally now just want to paint in a little bit of extra shape. So what I do is I start by going around the hairline and the areas of the face. Okay, and then I give the nose a bit of shape. What you want to do now is you want to avoid a dirty look. So you don't want to make the face, start making the face look dirty. Bit of shape. Okay, now I'm going to do this area just a little bit too much. Right, we obviously don't want that. So easy fix, instead of painting with your white, you just push X, swap over to black. I'm going to pull my opacity up to 100% and you just brush that out again. Okay, turn that back, 20% and we can go. Okay, cool, so this is looking pretty good, and again you can just check how it's looking like by toggling the layer on and off. Okay, so after working with a big brush, what I'll do is I'll go in and start with a finer detail. So now for the eyebrows, I'll move that up maybe to about 70%. Sticking on my burn layer, I'm just going to brush over the eyebrows just a little. There we go. Okay, while I'm here, I'm going to work on the pupil just a bit. I'm going to jump over to my dodge layer. Work on the highlight there. Move down the lips. When doing this, you want to avoid a small brush. Okay, burn, move that down, maybe back down to 40%, and just give that mouth a little bit of shape we're looking for. Okay, cool. Maybe just add a little bit onto the hair. Also a neat way to give hair a bit of volume. Move that up maybe back up to 70. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to select both layers, pull it down to my group folder over here and call that Dodge and Burn. Now looking back at the image, you can toggle the group on and off. This is a little bit strong for my liking. Now you can go back and adjust each layer the way you want it. I'm going to maybe lighten the shadows there. Select the oval effect and pull that down a bit. Okay, to your liking. So there you have it, a nice, easy, non-destructive way to do your dodging and burning. Great, thanks for listening.